So hey guys, welcome to this new video, and in today's section we will be going to see what are the three elements of setting up a policy, right? We will see what are the three elements which you have to consider when you set up a health and safety policy. So a policy is normally presented in three sections or elements. These three elements are general statement of intent, organization section, and the third one is arrangements section. So the first one we will see, the general statement of intent. The organization's philosophy in relation to the management of health and safety will be included in general statement of intent. So let us see in more detail. So in general statement of intent, in your statement, like in company statement, you should list your company's aims for health and safety. You should use simple language. You, as the owner or most senior person in the company, should sign and date the statement. Guys, note it is for the company owners and management, okay? Don't consider you as the health and safety professional here. This is purely for the company management. Now, you should also set a review date. You must also display your statement of intent where all employees can read it, for example, on the staff notice board. So let us come back to the second section, which is organization section. Organization section indicates the chain of command for health and safety management and identifies roles and responsibilities. So basically, this section of the policy lists the names, positions and roles of the people within your company who have specific responsibility for health and safety. So let us come back to the third section, which is arrangement section. It outlines the arrangements that exist for the effective management of health and safety in general terms. For example, how risk assessments are to be carried out. And also, it deals with the management of specific issues. For example, arrangements for ensuring the safety of visitors. So basically, the arrangement section gives details of the specific systems and procedures you have in place. This part of your policy should describe in detail how you control the risks associated with your business activities. You must tailor this to a specific business. For example, there is no point in describing your safety rules for dealing with chemicals if you don't use chemicals in your organization. So based on the what business your organization is doing, you have to tailor and customize your risk. You have to customize your regulations based on the what type of business activities your company is doing.